More now on South Australia's decision to reopen its border to New South Wales from midnight tonight if there's no community transmission today. South Australian Premier Stephen Marshall joins us now. Premier, good morning.
Good morning, Ali, and good morning to all your viewers.
Yeah, well, can I say thank you, thank you, thank you. There is a catch, though. Depends on case numbers this morning.
That's right. We still want to check out any new infections in New South Wales through to midnight last night, which would be the 14 days, the one incubation cycle, and see if there are any community transmission. But New South Wales has been doing extraordinarily well. So we're pretty confident that as of midnight tonight, the border with New South Wales, which has been closed for months and months, will reopen. And we can't wait to welcome people from New South Wales with open arms.
Well, I'll tell you what, school holidays start on Friday, so it's great timing. This must be a huge relief for families that have been separated and also for struggling businesses.
Spot on, Ali. That's exactly right. This has been massively a massive distraction for our economy in South Australia, and people have done it tough with family dislocation, business dislocation. All that comes to an end as of midnight tonight. So we're really looking forward. This has been based on health advice, but of course, very strong economic benefits from opening the border with New South Wales.
Okay. Now, I don't want to dwell on the negative, but say there is one case of community transmission today. What happens?
Ali, don't jinx it. Don't be so pessimistic.
What happens?
What is she doing?
How dare I ask the question?
I got an update towards the middle of last night, and there hadn't been anything that had been reported through. So we're pretty confident that it's going to happen. We do need to be careful. Our number one priority is to keep people safe here in South Australia. South Australia's done particularly well with a very low infection rate. Tragically, we've had four deaths in South Australia, but compared to many other parts of the world, that is a very different situation. So our borders have been our first line of defence. It's protected South Australia. The economy's moving in the right direction. Tens of thousands of people have now regained their jobs. In fact, in South Australia, Ali, only 7,000 fewer people employed in August than there was back in January this year. So things moving in the right direction in South Australia. And now welcoming people from New South Wales.
And breaking news on the Today Show from your very mouth, you're saying no community transmission we're going to hear today, so the borders absolutely will open at midnight tonight.
Well, we're very hopeful that that's going to be the case. We'll do those final checks.
No. Don't back away from this now. You said you had word, no community transmission.
Yeah, up until about middle of, I think about 7 or 8 o'clock last night, we hadn't had any reports, but of course it operates 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We're very grateful to New South Wales. We've got excellent data flow through to South Australia. So as of midnight tonight, we're hoping to be open to New South Wales, ACT, Queensland, Northern Territory, Western Australia and Tasmania. Things are looking much better in Victoria, but I think changing the border arrangements there, still a few weeks off.
Okay. So say moving forward, say in a couple of weeks' time, you do get, say, an outbreak in southwest Sydney. What happens then? Because a lot of people, they're wanting to book flights, say, for Christmas, to see their family. If you see an outbreak, do you then shut the border to the entire state? What's the plan?
Well, it's a really good question. We don't know what's going to happen with this disease, but what we do know is in Queensland, when they did have that outbreak after those two young women travelled down to Melbourne and then returned, they were infected. We didn't close off to Queensland. We sent some strong health advice to people that were visiting the same areas that those women were in, but we didn't close off those borders. But I can't say we'll never close off the borders again because we don't know what's going to happen. But what we do know is that the Public Health Administration in New South Wales is absolutely extraordinary. Good data flow, so we should be able to give people plenty of advice if we do need to make further border announcements.
And just quickly, when will you reassess the border situation with Victoria, and will you potentially consider opening just regional Victoria separate to Melbourne?
I think so, Ali. I think we're seeing very good numbers in regional Victoria at the moment. We know we've got a lot of South Australians that are over there at the moment that would love to come back. There are other people from other parts of the country and Victorians that would like to come over. We don't want to keep those borders in place for one day longer than they need to, but at the moment, the health advice is very strongly that we should keep that border arrangement in place. We do have that border community 40 kilometres either side of the South Australian-Victorian border, but we would obviously like to remove some of those restrictions when it's safe to do so.
All right, well, Carl and I are on our way, so thank you and we'll see you soon, hey?
Excellent. Thanks, guys.
And we're not leaving. Well, South Australia is not alone in welcoming back New South Wales. Queensland's extension of the border bubble with the state means thousands of tradies can finally get back to work. President of the Master Builders Association, Peter Liotta, joins us now. Pete, good morning to you. Hallelujah, huh?
Good morning, Carl. How are you?
Yeah, I'm pretty good. I'm not as good as you, though, this morning. It's been a long haul.
Look, it certainly has. I think the last 5-6 weeks, Carl, has been probably the most challenging that industry has seen or faced in a very, very long time. So we're certainly glad to both receive and hear the news that we did yesterday.
Give us an idea of the nightmare that was construction for you over the last 6 weeks. You had suppliers, workers on one side, you had the sites on the other. I'm surprised some of you didn't go to the wall.
Look, I think what we ended up facing, Carl, to be honest, we ended up in a scenario where we had about $150 million worth of residential and construction or residential and commercial work that had essentially stalled or ground to a halt, in addition to around $50 million worth of local government infrastructure work that has also stalled as well. So it's certainly taken its toll on the industry. It's certainly taken its toll on the community. And what this means essentially is that people can actually get back to work, start generating some revenue and leading to Christmas a little bit more positively than what we all thought we were going to previously.
Generally speaking, builders don't mince their words. What was it like? How did you feel? How frustrated did you feel?
Look, I think, to be honest, there's certainly a mental health aspect to all of this as well. What we did see, we had a huge amount of submissions that had come from the industry, both from building companies, from tradespeople, from mum and dad trades, from suppliers, from consultants, all expressing concerns, obviously. And it's incredible. I mean, if we look at construction, it makes up nearly 10% of GDP nationally. So it was absolutely paramount that provisions eventually were going or needed to be made for our industry. And we simply just needed to get people back to work.
Are these border changes enough, or would you like to see all of Queensland reopen?
Look, I think in time, our industry as a whole, what we did realise is there was certainly a need there to close the borders from a health perspective. What there needed to be very early on that we identified was some common sense, and a common sense approach, obviously, that everybody's been advocating for a long period of time. So, look, at the moment, what we do know is that the Gold Coast and the Northern Rivers, from a construction perspective, have always been intrinsically linked to one another. Mm. So it was absolutely critical to get those two communities back to work and back working together.
It'd still be a little bit frustrating, those borders. I'm just getting through them.
Yeah, definitely. Look, I think come October the 1st, obviously, a lot of those relationships that builders have had with their tradespeople, with consultants, again, with suppliers, there are going to be a lot of people that are rejoicing. And it does mean that the industry can get back to work. We're quite resilient. So, yeah. Again, it won't take long for our industry to bounce back.
And you want the home builder grant to be extended for another 12 months, is that right?
Look, definitely, there's certainly calls there for it to be extended. What we do know, the home builder grant does two things, essentially, Carl. So first and foremost, it provides an opportunity for young people to actually enter the housing market, which is wonderful. But what it also does is it buoys the remainder of the market as well. So it just breeds confidence. And of course, leading into uncertain times, you know, the more confidence that we have as an industry, the better for everybody.
Gee, it looks like Georgie Gardner's going all right. Those houses behind you, she's building a few up there, is she?
Look, Carl, I think we're going to see from October the 1st, we're going to see a lot more activity around than what we are at the moment. And I mean, as an example, where we're standing at the moment in Lennox Head, these streets ordinarily, it would take 10 minutes to be able to get a car park. So the very fact that you can park at the front at the moment is a sign of, I guess, where the industry is at right now.
She's always been ahead of the curve. Thank you so much, mate. And it's great news to have those borders a little bit more easy to navigate for all those builders, all those tradies. And let's hope there's much more to come for you guys. It's been tough here. Thanks so much, Ali.